Hey, this is the Black Belt Panda. So Tevo was kind enough to send me their Tevo Tornado 3D printer, so I figured we go ahead, unbox it, set it up, and I'll do some test prints for you guys so we can see how great it works right out of the box. So once we got this open, first thing we can see, boom. Okay, we got a manual, right? Instruction manual tells you how to set it up. We've got a spare print bed surface underneath this cover. We've got a spare PTFE tube. Spare parts are always great. We've got a USB cable. It's a little short for my liking. And we've got a power supply cable, a spatula for removing the prints from the bed. And of course, a bunch of parts bags. We've got brackets, we've got screws, there's zip ties, tools. There's even an included SD card for the 3D printer, which I think is absolutely amazing. Underneath this cover, we've got the power supply slash controller for the 3D printer. On the front, we've got the screen and controller knob, exhaust fans on the sides, electrical ports on the back, and a USB port as well as an SD card port on the other side. Here we have the upper gantry for the entire printer. And in the bottom of the box, we've got the lower base as well as the heated bed. And on the heated bed, we've got the test print that they do to the 3D printer to make sure it's working before they send it out. Very cool. So I'm gonna go ahead, take this out. I'm gonna set everything on the table just to make it a little easier to work with. So I love this color scheme, this black and green, absolutely amazing. I love black and green and black and red, and I believe the Tornado comes in black and red as well. At least I've seen pictures of it that way. But just, I love the way this looks. We got 5 different parts bags. Love the organization here. The packaging is amazing. So to set this up, we're gonna take the base, we're gonna place it beneath the upper gantry like so. And we're gonna take the included M5 by 25 screws, pass them through a locking washer through the bottom of the base and into the upper gantry. We gotta do this on both sides. There's 2 on each side. I recommend doing 1 on each side first to hold it together and then going back and putting the other 2 in. And of course, once those screws are in, grab the appropriate Allen key, go ahead and just tighten them down nice and good. Those locking washers will hold them in just fine. There we go, we got the upper part attached to the lower part. After that, we need to put the brackets in on either side. So we take the little green brackets, we put the included screw right through it, and on the other side, we tighten down one of the special nuts. These are like little rectangular nuts designed to fit in the channels of the frame. There's 4 on each of the brackets. We're gonna do the bracket for the right side of the printer first because it's easier. And once you've got them tightened down, just orient them so the 2 bottom ones are horizontal and the 2 top ones are vertical. And they should fit right into the channels. So we just pop that into place. Then we can grab the appropriate sized Allen key and just tighten all 4 of those screws right down. Looks good. With that side done, we can do the same on the other side, except this time we're gonna place this end stop board on the bracket. This just goes right over the bracket, and then there's 2 slightly longer screws that are gonna go through the end stop board, through the bracket, and then you put another one of those special rectangular nuts on the backside, tighten it down. So it looks like that. And then of course you place the 2 shorter screws on the bottom where the end stop does not connect to the bracket. And with all 4 of those tightened down, you can go ahead and orient them in the proper direction again. The bottom 2 should be horizontal and the top 2 should be vertical. And just like the other one, it pops right into place on the frame as long as everything's lined up. And you can grab the appropriate Allen key and just tighten it down. All right. Now with that done, we can place the power supply to the left of the printer. And we can start hooking up the cables. The upper gantry cable is an 8-pin connector. It only goes in 1 way, so don't force it. Line it up, press it in gently, and once it's in all the way, you can tighten the collar down to secure it. Next, I'm going to install the heated bed. So I'm going to place that right on top and I'm going to pass the long screws down through the bed and then down through the included springs and then the screws will pass down through the base, and underneath the base I can tighten those screws down with the adjustment knobs. I'm going to do this for the back as well. Pass the long screws through the bed, then through the springs, through the base, and tighten it down with the included adjustment knobs. Now I can plug it into the power supply. This is a 4-pin connector, and once again it only goes in one way, so don't force it. Line it up, press it in gently, and then tighten the collar down to secure it. With that done, we can do the rest of the cables. I'm going to start with the Y-axis cables. So I'm going to plug in the Y-axis motor cable, as well as the Y-axis end stop cable. And then I'm going to move on to the extruder and X-axis cables. So I can plug the extruder motor in, the X-axis motor, and the X-axis end stop. And that just leaves afterwards the Z-axis cables. So once again, plugging in the Z-axis motor, and then the Z-axis end stop. They can be a little tricky, but it's doable. Now we need to make sure that the wheels are all tightened. So just try to turn the wheels by hand. If you can turn them freely without applying any force, then they need to be tightened down. So we just use the included wrench to do that. Check the wheels on both sides of the 3D printer as well. And with all the wheels tightened down, make sure you tighten down the rest of the screws all around the printer. Sometimes they're loose. And don't forget to check the extruder screws, because if these are loose, the extruder may not grab the filament and it may slip when it goes to print. And the hot end moves just fine, so that's great. With that done, we can use the controller to move the hot end to the front left of the board, and then use the adjustment knob under the bed to lower it so that there's a slight gap between the hot end and the bed. Then do the same with the other three adjustment knobs to slightly level the bed out before we actually level it. To level it, we're going to set the temperature using the controller to preheat to PLA to bring the whole bed up to printing temperature. Then we can take an A4 piece of paper and slide it under the hot end, and then we're going to use the adjustment knob to raise or lower the bed until the hot end just barely grabs the piece of paper. We use the controller to move the hot end to the front right of the bed. And then we're going to do the same thing on that side. We're going to slide the piece of paper under it. And then we're going to adjust the knobs until the piece of paper is just barely grabbed. Do the same on the back right. And on the back left. With those four done, check the center. And if it doesn't fit under the center properly, then do all four corners again until it does. And once it fits under the center properly and is just barely grabbing, we can start printing. So here I started up a print. I changed no settings. We're printing at the default ABS temperature of 220 degrees for the extruder and 80 degrees for the bed. 20% infill with a 0.2 millimeter layer height. And once it's done, we can just pop it right off the bed. And we've got a cool little Marvin keychain. Now this came out pretty darn good in my opinion for having not tweaked anything. There are a couple layers that look like they're starting to delaminate, but again, that can be fixed with just a little bit of tweaking. These settings are straight out of the box. With that done, I'm going to fire up another print for something that's a little bit better at testing various aspects of the printer. We're testing with the Benchy Benchmark Boat. This is pretty cool because it'll check things like the roundness of your holes on both vertical and horizontal surfaces, the vertical thin columns, bridging, arching. It's just got a lot of great tests to it in a small, easy to print package. Doesn't take long to print, doesn't take much filament to print, and frankly, it's cool to have around as a little decoration when you're done. Not a lot of benchmark prints double as decoration, so bonus points for that. All right, with that done, we can see it definitely came out pretty darn good for not having tweaked anything. We've got pretty round holes on the front all around. We've got great bridging, great arches. All the shapes look fine. There's a little bit of waviness. There's a little bit of that salmon skin texture that's typical with the Tevo Tornado. But again, this hasn't been tweaked at all. There's of course a couple layers that look like they want to delaminate, but look, we can even see the letters and numbers on the back of the boat. That is really cool. I think it came out pretty darn good. So all in all, I highly recommend this printer from the results that I've seen straight out of the box. But that's it for now. If you guys like this video, please click that like button and let me know in the comment section down below, because I will be more than happy to make more of these 3D printer videos for you guys if you want to see them. So this is the Black Belt Panda. Thanks for watching. I will see you in the next video. Bye.